Okay, so now for the answer. Let's switch back to the code for a moment, and we'll even put in an example just to see what it actually does. You should have already done this, but just in case you haven't, let's run this and see what it does. So we put in 4 and 5. It came out with 20. That actually should be enough for you to figure out which of the answers that I gave you is correct. It's clearly computing the product of these two, at least in this example. But why in general is that what it's doing? So let's actually take a look at the code and see what happens. So we start off with A and B. We leave them alone, but we put copies of them into X and Y. And we have a Z variable that we initialized to 0. And then what we're going to do is we're going to keep decrementing x, keep subtracting 1 from x until it hits 0. And each time we subtract 1 from x, we add y into z. So we're starting off with z as 0, and we add y to it how many times? X times. So z at the end of this is y added to itself x times y. So it is, in fact, computing the product of these. Now, that was kind of an informal argument. Can we be a little bit more formal and mathematical to show why it is that what this is computing is the product of A and B?